spent time in the Congo, and he is walked to the ring by Arnel Bamatillo and also the Queensland heavyweight champion, I speak of Mick Petchy. And the big bloke is here, so too Arnel. He is the jungle boy. Very quiet, very relaxed, extremely composed. But for how long? Oh, here it is, the music. Shannon Taylor, a little bit of Rocky. And when you're at the fights, if it's not AC/DC, it's this that blares out on the speakers. Let's ride it in with the Bullet Blaster, Shannon Taylor. To jump center ring, quite the entourage with him, trainer Frankie John Gatt back by his side. But can anyone control the blaster? Both warriors are center ring, both wandering around, the nervous energy inside them. Let's go center ring to Rick Powell.
Ladies and gentlemen, live here on Fox Sports, we now bring you our main event of the evening. This 12-round event is for the vacant WF Middleweight Championship of the World. As we now take you to the red corner for the final time this evening and introduce to you a true character of the ring. Born in La Paz, Bolivia, he made his professional debut in the African Republic of the Congo in 2003. Today he calls Chevron Island on the Gold Coast his home. Arnel Bamatillo trains him at the North Sydney PCYC. Tonight he's tipped the scales at 72.5 kilograms, wearing his familiar Black Mamba snakeskin shorts. He brings to us tonight a record of 19 bouts with 14 wins thus far, 5 of those by way of knockout. Here's the current Queensland Super Middleweight Champion. Let's hear it for the Jungle Boy himself, Sonny Michelangelo! And now across the ring and in the blue corner, we introduce to you the current IBF Australasian Junior Middleweight and Middleweight Champion. Here's one of Australia's most enduring boxers and has represented us proudly on the world stage. Living in Figtree on the New South Wales South Coast and boxing out of the North Wollongong PCYC, John Gadd, his trainer. His weight officially recorded at 72.5 kilograms. He has blasted his way through 53 bouts, recording 45 wins and 2 draws. 31 of those wins by way of knockout. Ladies and gentlemen, it's time to introduce you to the Bulleye Blaster, Shannon Taylor! And in charge of the fight action centering, Chris Anderson from Victoria, judges Gary Dean, Mick Hafey and Des Bloyd, your timekeepers Bernie McMahon and Evan Bussell. Ladies and gentlemen, it's time to get down to business!
Here we go, WBF title on the line at middleweight. It's calm. It is the calm before the storm.
It's the stare, okay, Tom. Boys.
Sonny's remember what we said in the dressing room? Protect yourself at all times. Listen to me at all times. There's a neutral corner there in case of a knockdown. You'll go there and stay there until I signal for you to come out. If you come out before, I'll stop the count. Okay? Nice and tidy. Good luck, boys. Good luck.
Here we go. Sonny Michelangelo on screen now. There is Shannon Taylor. 12 rounds over 3 minutes is the journey. Sit down, buckle up. It may start quietly, it may start cautiously, but the fuse has just been lit. It's not a matter of if, but matter of when. Taylor tagged early. Taylor tagged Cole.
Yep, he was just hit with that right hand.
Over at top again, Sonny Michelangelo. As crazy as a cut snake. Angelo. Shannon Taylor at his absolute best as a boxer or fighter when that left hand is working. And the left hand is established early. Moving into round one. Shannon a little unsteady after that opening shot. Jeff?
Well, it might have made him just think a little, but here he comes. That's going to get behind his jab.
At middleweight, the limit of 72.57 kilograms. Trying to buckle Taylor down low with that left hand, the rip into the body. Sonny Michelangelo, who comes into the contest, 19 bouts, 14 wins, just 5 inside the distance. Two clash and lock up for the first time.
Oh, Taylor. Taylor cut big time. Sonny Michelangelo has blown up. Oh, no, this is finished. No. There is no way this can continue.
It's a big cut to the top of the head.
It is massive. It's anticlimactic.
It's up to the doctor. It's a technical draw, mate, anyway.
It's a technical draw, Shannon. Very disappointed.
What do you say? What do you say, Doc? Yes or no?
Sonny Michelangelo is claiming victory. That is not the case. It is a technical draw, and that is the most severe cut I think I have ever seen on a boxer. Angelo dancing. Taylor absolutely filthy.
Technical draw.
A technical draw is the decision. Unhappy here at Cronulla, but if anyone was able to be up close to see the size of that cut, it is horrific. The old Lang Park chant is going up here. Let's have a look at the incident, Jeff.
No, it was an accident. Shannon saying he drove it, but it was at the same time. He made a punch, which he went to the side, and he's come up with his head.
Let's have a look at the overhead.
It's going to be the same.
Both guys went in.
Both dipped to one side each.
And you knew straight away, Taylor is absolutely furious. Taylor is furious in the ring. He wants to go on. He is blowing up big time. We might have seen the end of this one. Shannon's just having a chat with us here. Trying to calm down the blaster. Having a look at Mick Croucher. He's also wanting to chat to Sonny Michelangelo, but there is no way you can continue, Jeff, with that type of cut. He is still on the front foot, the Bulleye Blaster. Still adamant that Sonny Michelangelo intentionally headbutted. Sonny
Money Mike Lanslow sitting calmly in the corner. Let's have another look at it.
No, it was in the same action as the punch.
Yeah, it was.
And, you know, as much as I, you know, I'm Shannon's mate, but, you know.
Yeah, I'm Shannon's mate too, but I'm not going to hide that fact at all. And it was a big night for Shannon, but... Yeah. And as anticlimactic as it is, there is no, for my opinion, no intentional headbutt there.
No, it was in the action of making punch, missing, punching.
Might see if we can get the blaster down here.
He can have a look at it for himself.
He can have a look at it for himself. He's not finished arguing it though, Shan. Big night, fight number 54 for him.
No.
Let's go to Rick Powell.
Ladies and gentlemen, in 1 minute and 57 seconds of round number one,
still,
we are going to the referee for the reasons for the decisions made.
The decision was made that it was an on-purpose head clash. Therefore, he got cut. The doctor stopped the fight. Therefore, Sonny Michelangelo gets disqualified. He wins.
Oh. Oh. Now Sonny Michelangelo's filthy. Sonny Michelangelo storms out of the ring. Arnel Barrichello trying to control the Jungle Boy.
So there you have it, ladies and gentlemen.
Oh, the promoter's
Sonny Michelangelo has been disqualified.
And things
ladies
are starting
and gentlemen,
to get a little bit wild here. Oh, the emotion a big time.